Hey everyone, and happy Disney planning! I wanted to make this video to help make your park experience as smooth and as efficient as possible. I like to define myself as an efficiency expert, not just with vacations, but with everything in life. But I think efficiency is a much more important thing when you are on vacation. You don't want to waste any time. By the end of this video, I hope to make you a Disney Parks efficiency expert. Too often I've seen parents and couples fighting in the parks, and to me, and what I'm looking at, I think that they just didn't prepare themselves for how Disney actually is. Gone are the days where you just show up to Disney. You have to have a strategy and you have to have a plan and know how to attack it. In this video, I'm going to help you with that. Here's what we're going to go over in this video. We're going to go over some Disney terms that you need to know before you go to the parks. By the end of this video, you're going to be a lightning lane expert and a Disney efficiency expert. You're going to save so much time in the park. I'm going to talk about the differences between Disneyland and Disney World. Stick around to the end of this video because I'm going to give you a few lightning lane strategies that will help you save time in the parks and maximize the amount of rides you get to ride, as well as tell you the worst strategy you can do that will not save you any time at all. So let's get to it, shall we? First, let's get in the terms I'm going to talk about in this video. Genie Plus. That's the service that lets you use Lightning Lane entrances at select attractions and experiences. This can include rides, characters, parades, and even the fireworks shows. Next, we have Lightning Lane. It's a virtual line at Disney that allows you to skip the standby line completely for all the attractions and experiences. Then you have individual Lightning Lanes, which is just a little bit different. These are not offered through Genie Plus. Instead, you can purchase these separately even if you don't buy Genie Plus. Then we have virtual queues. Basically, it's only offered for certain rides in certain parks. It's free to do, and you start standing in line virtually at 7 a.m. I'll give you the best strategy for this in a bit. Then we have mobile ordering. This is pretty plain and simple and to the point, but basically you order food through your phone, have it set for a certain time, and then you don't have to stand in line for it. It saves so much time. A term you need to get to know is rope drop, and I'll talk about that a little bit later. And last but not least, we have the DAS Pass, the Disability Access Service Pass. I'm gonna briefly just go over this because I know that they are changing this in the near future, but I want you to know what this service is and who can use it. So now that you kind of know what those terms are, I can really go into detail on how this all works and what are the best strategies to maximize your time in the park. First, let's talk about rope drop. Rope drop is a term used, basically you are standing in line to get into the park before the park even opens. You need to adapt this strategy because if you get there right as a park opens, you're going to be able to hop on so many rides before it gets crowded. Disney's rides are the most efficient at park open, so they get people in there and fast. If you're a resort guest, you can take advantage of this and go 30 minutes before the park even opens for everybody else. Let's talk about Genie Plus. Genie Plus is a service you can buy that allows you to have access to scheduling your rides, the Lightning Lanes. You can buy this at midnight, the day of, and on busy days, this will sell out. The price of Genie Plus fluctuates from park to park. It can start at $15 and I've seen it go as high as $39. So when budgeting for your tickets for the parks, definitely budget for Genie Plus. I promise you're gonna find so much value in it and you're gonna save so much time and ride so many rides and do the things that you wanna do in the parks. So the virtual line for each ride is called Lightning Lane. If you are staying at a resort, you can make your first selection at 7 a.m. If you are not staying at the resort, you have to wait till you get to the park, and when the park opens, that's when you can make your first selection. When can you make your next Lightning Lane selection? The quickest way to make your next Lightning Lane selection is to cash in on the ride that you selected first. For example, if you scheduled Jungle Cruise at 9:30 a.m., the minute you scan in for Jungle Cruise, you can make your Lightning Lane selection at that point. Otherwise, you have to wait 2 hours to make your next Lightning Lane selection. And real quick, something I learned this last vacation is if you are a resort guest and you can make a 7 a.m. selection, your 2 hour window doesn't start at 7 a.m. It actually starts when the park opens. So you may have to wait till 11 a.m. at the latest to schedule your next Lightning Lane. A good example of this is we selected Slinky Dog for 5 o'clock at night. Well, we couldn't cash in till 5 o'clock at night. So we had to wait that 2 hour window to be able to select the next ride for us. And here in a bit, I'm going to share which rides you need to focus on and which rides are going to sell out the quickest for Lightning Lanes. Does everyone get that? I hope so. Okay, so next we're going to talk about individual Lightning Lanes. I know Disney likes to make these terms super complicated for you. Individual Lightning Lanes are only offered by certain rides. And you do not need to purchase Genie Plus in order to reserve these individual Lightning Lanes. The same rule applies to Lightning Lanes as it does individual Lightning Lanes. If you're a resort guest, you can make your first selection at 7 a.m. Otherwise, if you are not staying at a resort, you have to wait till the park opens. You can also hold an individual Lightning Lane and a regular Lightning Lane at the same time. So a good example of this is, let's say you schedule Jungle Cruise for 10 a.m. You can also go in at 7 a.m. and buy a Lightning Lane for Tron. The prices for individual Lightning Lane can vary depending on if the park is busy or not, but it does start at $10 and it goes all the way up to $30 as of this video. Here are the rides you can purchase with individual Lightning Lanes, both at Disneyland and Orlando. At Magic Kingdom, it's Seven Dwarfs Mine Train and Tron. Epcot, it's just Guardians of the Galaxy. Hollywood Studios is Rise of the Resistance. Animal Kingdom is Avatar Flight of Passage. Disneyland is Star Wars Rise of the Resistance. And Disneyland California Adventure is Radiator Springs Racers. Now that we've kind of gone over the difference between individual Lightning Lanes and regular Lightning Lanes, let's talk about which Lightning Lanes will sell out the fastest, the ones that you need to watch. If you want to ride these rides, definitely book them early in the day as quick as possible. Starting at Magic Kingdom, these are the rides that are going to book up the fastest. Seven Dwarfs, Jungle Cruise, Space Mountain, Thunder Mountain, and as of this video, Tiana's is not open, but I guarantee when it opens, that's going to be quickly to sell out too. At Animal Kingdom, you have Flight of Passage and River Na'vi, and some days, Kilimanjaro. At Hollywood Studios, it's Rise of the Resistance, Smuggler's Run, and Mickey's Runaway Rail, as well as Slinky Dog. And I really just want to talk about Slinky Dog real quick because that's going to sell out first thing in the morning. You will probably not see Slinky Dog unless you're a resort guest. So when we went, we booked Slinky Dog right at 7 a.m. because we were staying on resort, and it was booked up within minutes. So sadly that day, only resort guests were allowed to have the Genie Plus Lightning Lane availability to book Slinky Dog. Everyone else just basically had to wait in line that day. So if you want the best advantage for your Hollywood Studios day, if you really want to ride Slinky Dog, definitely stay on property because you will be able to book it at 7 a.m. as opposed to when the park actually opens. In Epcot, the Lightning Lanes that will book fast are Remy's, Frozen, Test Track, and Mission Space. And just to take it a little step farther, Disney decided to complicate your Disney vacation just a little bit more and added virtual queues to all the newer rides. And here's what that is. So virtual queues can be booked through the app just like everything else. And it starts at 7 a.m. and 1 p.m. for everybody, no matter if you're staying on property or off property. If there are extended hours that day at the park you're at, they may have like a 6 p.m. or 7 p.m. virtual queue as well. There are only two rides that offer virtual queue in Florida, and that's Tron and Guardians of the Galaxy. In California, at California Adventure, it's their World of Color. Each time we do virtual queues, we nail it. We are under 20 boarding every time. We are one of the first ones to be on the ride every single time we do virtual queue. We are so efficient with it. So here is my best strategy for you. Since virtual queues start at 7 a.m., here's what I want you to do. I want you to get on your phone, get the app ready. At 6:58, you're going to keep refreshing. Join virtual queue. Keep hitting that button. Join virtual queue. Sometimes it drops a little earlier than 7 a.m. And this goes the same for the 1 p.m. and maybe 6 or 7 o'clock p.m. for extended hours. If you happen to be on Wi-Fi, if you're not at the park yet, then take your phone off Wi-Fi and just use the mobile data. By using this strategy, I promise you're going to get in that virtual queue and ride that ride you absolutely cannot wait to go on. So really, you can have 3 rides booked by the beginning of the day. You can get in line virtually for the virtual queue for Tron. You can book another ride with a lightning lane, and then you can buy an individual lightning lane for Seven Dwarves if you want. So you're already virtually standing in line for 3 rides, which is going to save you so much time and so much headaches from standing in lines. Let's quickly go over mobile ordering. The best thing you can do for this strategy is to study the maps of the parks ahead of time. If you go on the app, you can click on dining and you'll be able to see in each area of the park what restaurants and shops offer the mobile ordering. That way you are prepared ahead of time. You kind of know who offers what in what area of the park, so you're not waiting around in lines. Next, I want to talk about the disability pass or the DAS pass. If you or someone in your party has a condition that allows you to not stand in line, then you can go through Disney and get approved for the disability pass. You can register for this pass up to 30 days before your vacation or even the day of the parks. But if you want to save time, definitely apply for it before you get to the parks. If you are approved for the pass, you can schedule your times to return to a ride right in the My Disney Experience app. And finally, I want to talk about rider switch, which is something my family utilizes quite a bit because we have 3 young ones and not all of them can ride all of the rides yet. When you go to ride a ride that one of your littles cannot ride, you will go to the cast member at the beginning of the ride line and say, "Hey, I need a rider switch," and they're going to set you up right then and there. This allows one parent to stay behind with the kiddos that aren't quite tall enough to ride the ride yet, while the other one can go ride the ride either by themselves if your kids are not tall enough to ride the ride, or take the kiddos that are tall enough to ride the ride. When the first parent is done riding the ride, all you do is go scan your magic band or card at the lightning lane entrance, and then you can get right in the ride. You don't have to wait in line at all. And something kind of fun for the kids who are tall enough to ride the rides, they can ride the rides multiple times. So the cast member will ask who's riding the ride again. They will scan the cards or magic bands, and those kids can actually ride it again. Doing the rider switch at Disney parks is just another way for you to save time at the parks. I hope I was able to explain those terms the best and easiest way possible. I hope this makes you an expert by the end of this video, and I hope that you save so much time in the parks. Now let's get on to the differences between Disney World and Disneyland. It's a small difference, really. Basically, it's how you scan into the ride. So at Disneyland, you actually scan your phone or your magic band at the beginning of the ride. At Disney World, you actually don't scan your phone at all unless you have an Apple product. I don't have Apples, but apparently there is a way for you to scan your virtual queues and lightning lanes through that. Otherwise, you just use your magic band or the card they give you at the beginning of the day. Okay, you've made it this far. I hope you are well-knowledged in your terms of Disney. Now I'm going to talk about the best and worst strategies to maximize your time in the park, to get as many rides and experiences in your day as possible. Because let's face it, unless you're a Disney season pass holder and living in Florida, you're not going to have that much time you get to go to Disney. So I hope that this strategy maximizes your time and gets you so many rides in the parks. So let's get the worst strategy you can do to maximize your time in the park out of the way. So what I don't want you to do is to explore lands all at once. What do I mean by this? So if you go to Tomorrowland, you don't go to Tomorrowland, ride all the rides there, and then go on to the next land. That's not going to save you any time in the parks. If you want to maximize the rides you get to ride throughout the day, do this strategy instead. You're going to open My Disney app, head over to the Lightning Lanes, and go to Tip Board. Then you're going to see all the Lightning Lanes you can schedule throughout the day. As you scroll, you're going to see times associated with each ride. So like I said earlier, the most popular rides are going to sell out of Lightning Lanes by the end of the day. So if you really want to ride those rides, I would focus on those first. Book those before they sell out. This next part is going to require just a little bit of walking and a little bit of hustle. Find a ride with the next available time, even if it is all the way across the park. So let's say you're standing at the Little Mermaid ride and you notice that in 20 minutes, Jungle Cruise is open. Book it immediately and then haul it all the way across the park to that. When you get to Jungle Cruise, you can scan and then book your next Lightning Lane right as you do that. This is going to be your strategy the rest of the day. Just go through the tip board and start picking the rides that have the next availability. If you adopt this strategy, you will hardly wait in line until you get to the end of the day. That's when it gets a little bit more complicated. Toward the afternoon and evening, you might have to stand in a few rides because that's when Lightning Lanes start selling out. However, if you've been booking Lightning Lanes all day long, not standing in any lines and maximizing the amount of rides you get to ride, then it's okay to stand in a few rides throughout the day. You're still gonna save a ton of time. If you find yourself in a situation where you have to wait 2 hours to book your next Lightning Lane, that's a good opportunity to A, go stand in a ride for a little bit, because now you're standing in not one but two lines at the same time, or get something to eat, go explore some shops, go meet some characters. There's lots of stuff you can do while standing in virtual lines. So while this strategy may require a lot of walking throughout the day, that's okay. That just allows you to eat just a little bit more yummy Disney snacks, doesn't it? One thing I forgot to mention is that if you book a Lightning Lane or virtual queue and the ride shuts down, when that happens, you're gonna see in the My Disney app where you book the Lightning Lane, it's gonna give you a ticket to come back any time of the day. I hope this video helps you plan your Disney vacation. Planning for a Disney vacation can be super overwhelming, but with a little bit of studying, you can make it as efficient as possible. Study the app, study the wait lines, look at the Lightning Lanes before you even go. You can still look at it even if you're not at the parks. This is gonna help you get to know the park a lot easier and a lot faster before you even arrive.